What's up, guys? Welcome back to the FNG Academy. Buck here, former Green Beret, here to help you guys get selected. Alright, guys, so here is my ruck. Obviously, right out the gate, you can hear kind of how noisy it is. That was like really one of my biggest complaints with this thing. Is you hear that? Like up on the shoulder straps, it gets super noisy. It was okay when it's like 30 to 40 pounds, 50, but you're almost never at that weight in small unit tactics. I bought this rucksack in small unit tactics for small unit tactics. And once you got up to like 80, 90 plus pounds in your ruck, which yes, you will get to, this thing got super noisy. So if you find this ruck, I don't know if they make them anymore. Tactical Tailor makes it. Like I said, it's the Alice pack, but this is the Malice, the modified Alice. So if they still make it and you end up getting this one, I highly recommend figuring out a way to stop that squeak. Maybe put something on the frame or tape up the frame with electrical tape. I don't know what you got to do, but put something on there because that squeak is annoying as shit and it's not very tactical at all. Tactical Tailor. Tactical is in the name and you're not being tactical. The shit is that? Alright guys, this video is sponsored by 18 Alpha Fitness. If you want to get through selection and you want to be physically prepared and ready to go and have the confidence going into selection, then go check out Kevin over at 18 Alpha Fitness. Tell him Buck sent you, he will hook you up. Be prepared physically, mentally, and be ready to go. Injury prevention is key and nobody handles that better than I've experienced than Kevin over at 18 Alpha Fitness. So make sure you go check him out. So let me show you guys just how I fit it and give you a couple tips on rucking and how to distribute the weight when you start to get a lot of aches and pains in your ruck. So let's throw this bad boy on. Like I said, this is my ruck. I like it. There are many like it, but this one is mine. Thick foam pads on the shoulders and then the thick cummerbund waistband at the bottom. So a lot of people don't understand like how to distribute the weight on their body, right? Well, a lot of us talk about distributing the weight inside of our rucksack, which is super important as well. So typically you'll have your sleeping bags, the things that you don't need for a while. So you're gonna take the sleeping bag and you're gonna shove it down in the bottom, right? Everybody starts with that. Every soldier forever starts with the sleeping bag at the bottom. A lot of times they'll make a zipper on the bottom of the rucksack. So that way, instead of pulling all your shit out, you could just undo the zipper at the bottom and then pull your sleeping bag out of the bottom to ruck out at night. I think the new Molly has a zipper at the bottom. I don't really remember. Because these things could be like fucking the purse from Harry Potter when shit just keeps coming out and coming out and coming out. And then you have a rucksack explosion because you had to pull everything out to get to one thing. That is the worst. So you'll see on the back of this pack that there's like a million pockets. Look at this. You have pockets on top of pockets. So you have front pocket here, another pocket, and then you got side pockets. And you think, wow, Buck, that's a lot of pockets. That's too many pockets. They overdid the pockets. It doesn't matter how many pockets you have, you're gonna fill them all up. So there's always places to put it. But it's important to decide what you need and where. So what are you going to need quick access to? What do you want to have readily available? Your moleskin, your socks. I always recommend change of socks. Can your rucksack get wet? Do you have it weatherproofed properly so when you go get that new pair of socks, you don't pull them out and you get a wet new pair of socks? So what you put in these outside pockets is super important. And you'll see you could just grab something right away and everyone else is struggling. You prepared your shit better. So yes, there's a lot of pockets on the outside and you will need them. You'll have a top. This one has a top pouch on that top flap. And then the straps loosen up like that and then go over and then connect at the bottom of the ruck. I know right now this looks like a mess. Let me fill it with some stuff to make it easier to see. All right, so now as I'm filling it, it's starting to take a little more shape. You could see what kind of ruck it is. And again, the cool thing about this one is the Malice, which again is replicated after the old Alice pack, which all the SF guys love. it kept this metal bar frame. And I think that's where they really got their satisfaction from that style ruck, is that metal bar frame. And then just the way that it places, see, it sticks out for your cummerbund. And I think that gave them a lot of comfort putting that forward into your lower back. So how you throw on your ruck is gonna be super important. A lot of guys think, you know, you're just gonna do this number. Yeah. Well, guess what? You get 90 pounds in your ruck, you are not throwing it on like that. So likely what you're gonna do is just set it on the ground. You're gonna crawl your ass in it, strap it all up, and then your buddy's gonna have to pull you up off the floor. Yes, that's how much weight we put in our rucks, is that a lot of times you can't get up on your own, is how much weight you got in there. So if you have to, you could do the turtle. If it's really heavy, roll onto your side and then push up like that, get on a knee and then step up. That's probably your best bet if you don't have any friends or they're just not willing to help you out. So here's the thing with distributing the weight inside your, for your body on your ruck, right? You got shoulders. Move this down a little bit. You got shoulders and then you have your cummerbund. So at some point, both of these things are gonna start hurting on your body, your hips and your shoulders. So what I'll do is I'll ruck as long as I can with all the weight on my shoulders. I don't have my cummerbund fastened, I leave it open. And as soon as that starts hurting, then I need to switch, I'll switch to my cummerbund. So what I'll do is I'll take a little jump, get that weight high up on my back, and then I'll strap my cummerbund. So once my cummerbund is strapped, you'll notice that my shoulders look light. Look, I could do this, and I have a ton of room in my shoulders. Now all the weight is distributed to my hips. So I'll ruck for as long as I can like that. Let my hips take the brunt of the weight. And then as soon as that starts hurting, I can start feeling it in my hips. I just switch back and forth. Release the cummerbund, shake that in, let it rest on my shoulders, and then let the pain begin on your shoulders. So knowing that and how to use the cummerbund to your advantage is huge. You're gonna wanna switch from shoulders to cummerbund, you know, hips to shoulders, as the pain gets too intense. And trust me, you start getting 80 pounds, that pain gets pretty intense. So that's an important one. The next one is how you pack the weight inside your ruck. Like I said, you're gonna want, let's say we're rucking, you guys are training, you're gonna want a 45 pound weight in there. You're not just gonna wanna shove it into the ruck, because you'll notice that when guys do that, their weight sits super low and it's bouncing and hitting them in the butt as they're rucking. That is bad day all day. The weight is working against you. You're gonna hurt your backs, you're gonna hurt your shoulders. So you wanna get that weight close to your back, close to your spine, and high as you can. Ideally, sitting high up in the rucksack. So right now you see there's no weight, there's no filler in the top of the ruck. It's because I took all the fluff, I took a sleeping bag and some uniforms and I just shoved it right to the bottom. So if I put the weight on, which let me do that right now. So now there's a 45 pound weight. So there's the top of the ruck, there's the frame, and you see how the weight is close and high. That's about as close and high as I could get this in there. It's all the way to the back of the rucksack, and it's about high up on that frame as I can get it. So the weight doesn't look super high, but that 45 pound plate is about as high and as close to my back as I can get it. The only way I can get it higher is if I shoved more filler into the bottom to hold it up. So that being said, when you guys are rucking and you're going out training, take filler with you, start practicing packing your ruck appropriately. You know, get some jeans, get some shirts, shove it into the bottom until you can move that weight high. So what that's gonna do is now, as I'm rucking, because that weight is sitting up high on my back, as I wanna step out, I can lean forward with my hips and move out. And that weight is gonna work to my advantage instead of working against me. You're not gonna get that ass slap while you're rucking, pulling on your back and your shoulders, and you can manipulate the weight with your hips forward and back. So, packing your ruck, weight close and high, and then learn how to distribute the weight from your shoulders to the cummerbund to your hips. All right, guys, I hope that helps a little bit, just to give you an idea of what kind of ruck I use, why I use it, and then how I manage my weight on my body and how I manage my load inside the ruck. I'm probably gonna redo this when my buddy Abel comes out. He's our videographer for the FNG Academy. He is currently swamped with projects we've been filming and recording, but he's coming out soon, so we'll do a reshoot of this where I record. He'll record for me the whole process and we could break down the whole process. But I wanted to get something out on rucks so you guys are seeing what I use. Do I recommend going straight to this? Honestly, you guys are gonna have to use the Molly in selection. The Molly pack on eBay is probably like 50, 60 bucks. So if you really wanna get used to the ruck you're gonna be using, which is a good idea for those of you guys that are, you know, 18 x-rays, I would save up and maybe look into getting the Molly, that standard issue, because that's what you're gonna have to use in selection. It's not till SUT, and maybe not even then, depending on the cadre, if you could upgrade your ruck later on. As soon as you can upgrade, I do recommend upgrading because it makes a huge difference. This ruck is night and day better than the Molly. The Molly's got thin straps. The cummerbund is thin. It's just hot trash. The cummerbund in selection on the Molly, and when I'm talking about the waistband, the cummerbund, in selection, I had to wrap socks around it because it was rubbing holes into my hips. So I don't know if I got them thick hips or what, or if I was just being a sissy about it, but I was bleeding on my hips from the traction it was creating because it's just rough material. There's no padding. So I had to, you know, shove socks on it. It helped a little bit, but not great. So the cool thing about that is that one, you could actually take off the frame and adjust it higher. So as to where you see, I'm kind of limited to how high I could shove the weight up in my rucksack with the malice pack. With the Molly, which you guys are gonna be issued, you could actually take the pack itself off the frame and then move that up. So that's what a lot of us did, is we took it off the frame and moved it as high as we could. That way, when you see that you can't pack that weight up any higher, you're still shifting that weight high up on your back, which helps a lot because I am very limited with this one, how high I can get that weight up. So just some things to think about, and I hope that helps you guys. Also, one thing to add, I did add water bottle, 2-quart canteen holders onto this one. They will sew it on for you at all the sew shops outside of Bragg. So if you get there a little early or if you find a sew shop, the 2-quart canteen carriers is money to have sewn on, because like I said, you want everything as readily accessible as possible. That being said, I do need to do a video on 2-quart canteens, where to place them, the straws, the canteen straws. Those things are amazing and will save you from getting dehydrated. Lots to come. So thank you guys, I appreciate you. Make sure you go check out the fngacademy.com, the store. We have a ton of cool content coming your way. All right, guys, that's the video. So do me a favor, click on one of these guys up here. This one, or is it up here? I don't know. I got nothing else to do. Go ahead, hit it, click it. You're not clicking it, are you? You wouldn't still be here if you were clicking it. I could wait for you to subscribe to the channel, show me some love. I'm stubborn, I'll wait. Did you just turn the outro music on me? What the? This is my channel. You don't fucking outro music me. Turn that shit off. I am not see it clearly, but it's obvious. I know that you love me.